Guys, it has happened. Guys, it has finally happened. Guys, Pokemon Sun and Moon have finally been released. Guys, Blue Yoshi here, and welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy! Last time, we did some chores around the Comet Observatory, saving Luigi from, a tree. I don't know how that worked. And we also did the Honeycomb Galaxy in the bedroom. Today, we are going back into the bedroom doing yet another larger galaxy. This one, I think, really fits the occasion here. See, the galaxy that we are going to be doing today is the Freeze Flame Galaxy, as you can see. So, let's fly to this galaxy. And remember, if you enjoy this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Seriously, guys, it, like, really helps. You have no idea, especially for us smaller YouTubers. Like, really, please, it helps. So, yeah, enough rambling. Let's actually get this party started here. So, let's go to the Freeze Flame Galaxy. The frozen peak of Baron Bull is our first mission. Yes. Welcome to the galaxy. Alright. Wow, Mario, you got some skills. Okay. What do you have to say to us? Hey, old man. I'm not that old, mate. Please respect your elders. Are you practicing how to skate too? Then why don't we play a game? Can you catch me? What's with all of these people, like, making fun of old men? Did Nintendo have, like... Did the person writing all the text for Nintendo was like... He probably just had, like, someone in his life that was exceedingly annoying. That was an old person, so he probably just decided to vent all his frustration into this game. That's how I explain it. Alright, let's... Wow, we, like, jumped on him. Wow, okay. Now what are you gonna say? Not bad old... Okay, so you're still gonna call us an old man even though we got you. Okay, that makes sense. With skating skills like that, you might have a chance. A small chance, maybe, but a chance. Wow, you clearly do not have any faith in me. Well, I will show you, okay? I will show you that I can do this. Let's blast off. Soaring through the sky, little your mom. Tournament 4 references! Except for the fact that only one of you got that, so... Yeah. Alright, so welcome to the main planet of the Freeze Flame Galaxy. Let's see what Billboard has to say to us. The water here is cold. Really, really cold. Seriously, if you fall in, it's going to hurt. Yes, that is making a good point here. If you actually go into the water in this galaxy, it will deal damage over time. So, yeah, definitely watch out for that. And yes, it can kill you. So, yes, watch out. Anyways, we have a new power-up right here. This is the Ice Flower. This is actually the first time it was in a game. This is its debut, not debut, people. Just want to clear that up. Yeah, and see the ice flower. I wouldn't make it all the way up there if I didn't, wasn't ideal. But yes, the ice flower, as you can see right here, makes frozen platforms under you, allowing you to walk on water like a certain other person that I know, that had a mustache, supposedly. Let me please get up here, please, thank you. Let's keep on going. So yeah, it allows you to walk on water. It also, you know, makes you look amazing, and you can skate on your own water, which is amazing. It comes at a price. The problem being is that, your spin is absolute trash. It literally does not help you one bit. So, I guess that is the trade-off here. I guess it kind of works because it lets you, you know, access areas that are previously inaccessible. Why do I always do that? Okay, let's get through here. Yeah. But, you know, it... Wow. Potatoes close much? Wow. Let's get back over here, please. Okay. So, yeah, as I was trying to say, yeah, it kind of comes with a trade-off there, but I think it's decent. It works. So yeah, that is the ice flower. One of my favorite power-ups in this game. Yeah, so let's get up here to the boss of this mission, being Baelin Bull, as you can see right here. Baelin Bull, he is quite an easy boss, to say so bluntly. I mean, here's the thing about him, is that he is on this, like, platform that is above the water. So, technically it is possible to fight him with only one ice flower, which I will be attempting to do, but it is quite difficult, because if you fall off, you know, you'll have to get another ice flower just to get back up. So, it is quite difficult in that respect. But yeah, so to beat him, what you have to do is spin around, get his ice powers away from him, and then, yeah, that's what I mean. Wow, did I seriously do that? Wow, that's amazing. Okay, please, no, please, no, please, oh gosh, dang it. Oh my gosh, please let us get on heal. Okay. Haha, I did not need it. Get drowned on, game, get drowned on. Okay, let's get this guy hoppable. I was not close enough. Alright, get trickshotted. Okay, he has one life left on his final phase right here, you can see. He has his little minion seal. And as we inflate our fists, we will defeat him. There we go. So, I do, however, really like these complimentary coins. I really do appreciate it. Anyways, one more thing before we grab the star. See this on the right here? For some reason, my cursor is not appearing on the Wii here, but yes, to the right, make note of that. We're gonna be there in a few minutes. Anyways, that is star number one today, and we got a star! Alright, that was a really bad voice crack, actually. Wow! But yeah, so let's go back into the Freeze Flame Galaxy. Today will be a longer episode. There was 5 stars that I want to get today just to finish off the Freeze Flame Galaxy so that we can get some pretty good, so that our next episode can be going to the next larger galaxy here and quickly finish up this dome. Anyways, our second star today is going to be Freeze Flame's Blistering Core. So, let's go. Alright, we got some lava right here. Let's blast off, soaring through the sky. Little Einsteins already made that joke. Shoot, okay. Welcome to the galaxy. Well, welcome back to the galaxy, actually. Okay, so we have to get 5 star pieces, as you can see right here. They will try to trick you with coins, but, yeah. They're pretty easy to find. You just need to have eyes. Wow, we hit that. I didn't fully expect to be able to hit that. Wow, okay. Let's grab this 4th one right here. 5th one is just on the other side right here. Let's grab it and make a launch stall. If we can, excuse me. There we go. Stall piece number 5. Why are there blue stars? We do not need blue stars, people, just so you know. Watch this. That was only a long jump. By this point in the game, I think you should know how to long jump, but, yeah, welcome to Freeze Flame's Blistering Core. Now, talk about some aspects of game design here, as it is one of my professions that I work on here. Now, if you go into full screen right now, if you aren't already, you should be able to see that the screen kind of has like this wavy, humid effect, is hopefully you can see right now, which is definitely evident if you're playing this on an HDTV, on the virtual console, on the Wii U, like I am at this point here. And, you know, I really appreciate this, because you can see, like, it makes you really feel like you're in this center of, you know, it makes you really feel like you're around, like, lava, okay? Because, you know, even if you're just by a campfire, you can kind of even tell, you can kind of even see this effect, too. So I really do appreciate how much effort they definitely put into this part of the galaxy here. But yeah, so now we have our second power-up of the day. This one is the Fire Flower, which is essentially really like the Ice Flower here. What it does is, when you spin, it allows you to shoot fireballs, you know, simple stuff like here. These fireballs will kill pretty much any enemy, and, well, it's on a timer. I forgot to mention that about the Ice Flower, but yeah, it's on a timer. So yeah, now, again, the spin on this, when it comes to platforming, is, yeah, it's quite bad. It's not favorable, okay? But, you know, it works, okay? So, and also, it does give you a little bit of hang time in the air. So, I guess that's something you can kind of use it to float over enemies, is what I was trying to say. Maybe not. Okay, gotta light these two torches. Music went silent there for a second. That was weird. Yeah, so, let's keep on going. Now might as well be as good of a time as ever to talk about this. So, yeah. Now, as I said at the start of this video, Pokemon Sun and Moon, recently just came out, and by recently I mean earlier today. So yeah, they came out earlier, and the internet exploded. But that's not what this is about. It's about what I'm going to be doing on my channel here, and yes, I will be doing a Let's Play on the game, and quite a special Let's Play, not a normal one, and I think that you guys will really enjoy the concept here, and whoa, what just happened there? But yeah, so, if you know Dennis, also known as Umbly Gaming, Jack, which is known as JP West, does gaming, wow, that was an epic save right there, and me, Blue Yoshi Gaming, we're all going to be doing a Let's Play on Pokemon Sun and Moon at the same time, simultaneously. They're going to be separate, obviously, but every few episodes, specifically whenever there's gyms or challenges or whatever the heck is going on, I'm going to be meeting up and doing battle and trading and showing off mechanics and stuff. So yeah, I think you guys will really enjoy that series and what I have planned for it. Now, due to it being on the 3DS and, you know, the fact that 3DS capture cards cost a gosh dang ton of money, it will take a while. Specifically, we're planning on starting it by Christmas, or at least a few days after Christmas, specifically 2017, is when we're aiming at planning it and starting it here. Possibly we can do it earlier than that, if we get any donations or anything, I don't know. At this point though, it's probably going to just be January of 2017. So yeah. Also, I'm going to be doing it blind. If you know me, I haven't been watching any of the trailers, I haven't been seeing any news related things on the game. The only thing that I've seen is a first trailer revealing the starters. So yeah, you could say that I've been keeping myself in the dark here for the enjoyment of you guys, so that, you know, it'll be a blind Let's Play, which is always, in my opinion, more fun than just watching, you know, a normal Let's Play. However, I wasn't satisfied with just leaving it at that, because, well, for people that don't really care about the blind aspect of it, it might just be boring. So, what I'm doing is I'm making it somewhat informational. If you guys have watched Sugar Conroy or my Pokemon Fire and Leaf Green series, you will have seen these Pokemon bios. And I'm going to be doing a similar thing for Pokemon Sun and Moon here. Which I think will be pretty enjoyable and, you know, will provide information for anyone playing along. So, yeah, that's what we're going to be doing regarding Pokemon Sun and Moon. I really hope that you guys enjoy the series. I'm definitely going to enjoy the series. But yeah, so, back into the game. We are inside the blistering core here with only 1 HP left. Wow, we are doing amazing here. Let's get a Fire Flower and light these torches, which is what we are supposed to do here. Yes. Oh, shoot. I remember that I don't have a very good spin. That's right. Okay, let's try again here. We got these little fire guys over here. Okay, let's go this way. Whoa, oh my gosh, we just barely made that. It's amazing. I think we can make this jump. Yes! Wow, that was extremely close. That was pretty scary, actually. Wow, okay, now let's actually light these torches here and get our second star today. Alright, wow. Come on, mate, that's just mean. I thought I could make it onto that moving platform. Come on. Okay, game, I would really appreciate it if I could just, you know, finish off this level here for you guys. You know, because I know that people don't enjoy just watching the same level over and over because someone has scrubitis at the moment. Okay, we should make that jump, yes. Okay, Fire Flower, let's light these torches yet again. Oh, well, technically last time we didn't light any torches because we have scrubitis, as I said. Okay, now this should hit the torch, yes. Okay, now we just need to hit the second one here. I think that should hit it. Yes, there we go. And the second star here is opened up. Let's go get it. I forgot that our spin is absolute trash. Yeah, let's get rid of that fire flower power. Please do not die. No. Please no. Please no. So much no. Okay. 2 HP. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Okay. Please. There we go. Okay. That is star number 2 today. And we got a star. I was a little more on key than last time. Wow. Yeah. Clocking in 17 minutes almost. Yeah, we're not doing too great on time, but I mean, what can you do at this point? I mean, we're doing 5 stars already today, so it was already going to be a longer episode, so yeah. Anyway, so our next star that we are going to be getting here is a Cosmic Comet here, which is just going to be the Freeze Flames. I want to say Cosmic Mario Race, if I got it right. Yes! Wow! Exactly correct. Frosty Cosmic Mario Race, not Freeze Flame. Okay, never mind. I was close, though. I was close. Alright, let's go. Let us race. It will let us drop. Okay, welcome to the galaxy. Now, quickly, I just want to say, this guy is named Cosmic Mario, not Shadow Mario. One guy corrected me at school. So, yeah. So you know, this is Cosmic Mario. It's a whole different character. Whole different character than Shadow Mario. That's what I was trying to say, though. Okay, 2 lives. Try again, please. Okay. Thankfully, my pointer is actually on point today. I love how you can just skip that. Okay. I keep on spinning. 2 only! Wow, I can contest to the fact that I did press A, so I don't know if I just did it too late, or it just simply did not get my button input. I don't know. This guy is so cocky, seriously, man. Okay, finally I didn't spin too early. Yo. Mario the Ballerina on ice. I thought that was a thing, Mario on ice. It's weird. Okay, let's go. Okay, now, I do want to say here that I really like what the ice looks like in this game. I think it looks really nice and crystal-like here. Yo, let's just get this jump here, and yes, that is our 3rd star today. There we go. Whee! Got a star. Alright, clocking in about 19 minutes. Let's go back into the Freeze Flame Galaxy! And go to our next mission, which will be Hot and Cold Collide. How do I know this? Because I've been trying to do this episode for the last, like, 5 hours. Seriously, it's like 9 o'clock right now. It's absolutely ridiculous how many times the recording fails. Like, it wasn't even my fault most of the times. It's just stupid. But anyways, yeah, Hot and Cold Collide. So, yes, this is probably my favorite mission in this whole galaxy here. Because of just look at this. Just look at this here. Do you see how amazing this looks? Ah, I could just lift you. It looks so nice. And obviously, it probably would not be a nice place to live because it's fireballs and stuff. But you know what? I'd be fine with living with fireballs as long as I get to be in a place that looks as magnificent as this. Like, look at this. Just, I said how much I like the ice in this game. Yeah, the ice and the fire mixed together just works so well, and I really like it. So yeah, that may be the only reason why I like this mission, but I guess this next one could technically be a reason why I like this mission. So yeah, now, look around yourself and you'll see the water, you know, moving up and down. You'll also see these sea urchins here. Take note of that. I'm going to be referencing it here in a second, just as we open this door here. Okay. But yeah, now, if we go to the other side here, it will be all lava here. That cut there, as I was saying though, God, it was kind of acting up here, and yeah, I kind of needed to do that. But yeah, so let's continue onwards with what I was trying to say and just our mission in general. So, like, you can see these, like, flame urchins or whatever the heck these are called. These, you know, are just like the sea urchins that we were just fighting a minute ago. So, you know, there's a parallel there. Also, the lava is, you know, sinking and rising, just like the water was right there. And also, the songs are literally just the same. And the Fire Flower and Ice Flower songs are virtually the same. You can kind of see how, I think they really represent the yin-yang, two halves of one whole, that are separate yet equal, you know? So, I think that's a pretty interesting theme of this galaxy here, but yeah, so let's blast off to our next area right here. Wow, my cursor does not want to act up today, does not want to point today, but yeah, so, okay, here's something that I really like about this galaxy. So, you unlock the, wow, how did I live that? Wow. You unlock the comet before you have access to this level. So it's basically impossible to do this part right here without first doing the comet. Well, technically you can do it without doing the comet because, you know, the comet dude in the front, you know, the purple dude, he can do it, but, you know, most of the time, you're gonna do the comet before you do this, and, well, it's quite easy. So, you know, whenever you do this, you know, you won't feel lost, like, I don't know what this place is, I don't know how to do anything, you know? So I think that's pretty smart on Nintendo's part. Also, just, you know, skating on lava. I mean, like, you can't tell me that this isn't your dream. I mean, come on. Skating on lava, just think of that. Just think of that. It's like amazing. Alright, so, have the star up ahead. Fourth. Nope. Mario Ballerina is too fabulous for the game to handle, I guess. Oh my gosh. Coastal, please. Like, okay, I'm not even moving my hand right now. Like, look at this. Do you see this? Just amazing. Okay, finally, it's about time my cursor got normal. I guess, kind of. Just as normal as my cursor can be, at least. Okay. Keep on doing this. I'm trying to grab these star bits, but the thing does not want me to grab anything. Oh, shoot. Okay. Let's grab this right here. Okay, thank you. Alright, let's go! Final stretch right here, Mario! Use your awesome dabbing skating skills! Hooray! And that is star number careful today. All right. Good deal. All right, so let's go back to the bedroom here. You know, as I said before, this is my favorite dome. Like, overall, there's so many great galaxies here, and I think I've pretty much summed up why I love Freeze Flame Galaxy just as much as I do Gusty Garden Galaxy. But yeah, without further ado, let's fly to this galaxy again and get our last star of the day. And yes, I do apologize for this being a slightly longer episode. I did want this to be, you know, as short as possible, and I think I shortened it as much as I possibly could. Doing five missions today, I mean, I think it's pretty impressive to get five missions done in, like, what, like 25 minutes? I don't know. I'm not keeping track of time right now, so. Yeah. Alright, let's follow this dude again. You know, this really points out something that I wish that Nintendo did. I really wish that, like, for talking to this penguin, that, you know, the second time around, they just quickly changed their dialogue, you know? And it wouldn't even be hard to do. Obviously, it wouldn't cost any money because, you know, employees and whatever. But I mean, like, I seriously think it's a missed opportunity. Like, I don't know. Just the fact that he still calls us old men. Or calls me an old man. He doesn't talk to you directly. Yeah, okay. Oh, shoot. That's not what I meant to do. Okay. Oh my gosh, my Koso is going absolutely ballistic right now. Grab this coin right here. He's on the other side. Alright. I think we've caught up to him right now. There we go. Alright. What do you have to say for you? Oh, nope. Not bad, old man. With skating skills like that, you might have a chance. So. Well, considering that I already got, like, four stars in this galaxy, I think I might have a chance. I don't know. I'm not going to claim... I'm not going to claim anything, either. Yeah, now, there is some things back on Freeze Flame Galaxy that I purposefully didn't show the first time around. Because, well... You know, I wanted to make this second one through, interesting. You know. So, first of all... let's see if I can get through here without getting hit. Okay, well, first of all, right here, there's this spot right here, which you probably have seen if you were very observant here. You have the sling star right here, and, you know, you got this nice little slide. The slide does not... It's not needed or anything, it's just like an added extra. But, you know, if you want to, you know, increase your life count, it's right there, so... Yeah, I definitely needed it with my only... with my 1 HP that I had, but also, I do want to point out this right here. Now, all across this galaxy, there is, like, these little, you know, whatever these are called. You know, and you can jump on. In fact, it's possible to make it all the way to, I can't even point, but you can make it pretty much all the way over to the ice flower without, going this way, you know, because you can just jump on those, and while they all quite precise jumps, I mean, I think it's quite nice that Nintendo added it. Now, you can see this part right here, and this, yes, is a shortcut. You could also make it just by, you know, jumping on here, and then doing that, also. Again, my cursor is acting up here, so it's kind of hard to show this, but yes. Now you hit this, and the sling star will appear, and yes, this is a pretty useful shortcut. So, if you are playing with me right now on Super Mario Galaxy, or, you know, you just are going to be playing this game, yeah, definitely use that shortcut. It's extremely useful. However, we need to get, let me see if I can use my first person here. We need to get up there. That's where we need to go. So we're gonna need our Ice Flower power up to jump on those, whatever this thing is, like, fountain, I guess? I don't know. Whatever these are called here. Yeah, okay. Oh, shoot, nope. Please, no. There we go, okay. Yeah, what you need to do for that is either do a triple jump, or, do... or do like a lily pus- like, when it's- you need it to end just as you spin. Because, as I said before, Ice Moya's spin is ridiculously bad, okay? So, yeah, anyways, we're going back into this galaxy with the Fire Flower power-up. Remember when I said at the start of this video that we'll be going back over here? This is what I meant to. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna need my Fire Flower for this. Okay. Oh my gosh, I thought I would not make that. That was scary. And yes, I do apologize for my coaster right here. It is so weird. I don't know what's going on. I'm literally not even moving my hands right now. It's like, okay. Wow, that was an epic dodge right there. But yeah, yes, you can kill these bats by shooting fire at them. I think that's the only way to kill them, you know, besides invincibility, stall, and okay. We might be able to live this. Please, no, please, grab onto ledge, please, Mario, please do this for me. I ask so little of you, Mario, gosh dang it. Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh, that's one way to die, I guess. I guess that works. Okay. Just get this fire flower. And you know, this reminds me. So, ever since Honey Hive Galaxy in episode 3, you know, there's always been, you know, these special power-ups. And, well, each power-up is, you know, normally in a crystal, like how we got this, where you have to spin it. Okay, well, this just oaks my game designer, part of me, because, this is so smart on Nintendo's, and it's just amazing. Okay, so first of all, okay, I need to explain something. So every game has kind of a, you know, a mechanic that it's based around, no matter what it is. And, you know, not all games, you know, the main thing is not a mechanic, but, you know, most Nintendo games, like Mario games or Zelda games, you know, they're based on a mechanic or, like, a feeling or something. So, for example, you know, Zelda is all about puzzles and dungeons and, you know, questing. You know, adventure, you know? You know, going into the unknown. Mario's main mechanic is the jump. That's what everything is based around. Everything from, you know, how things fall to, you know, where things are located. You know, every Mario game has jump as its main mechanic here. Now, most games, you know, have a secondary mechanic that makes it unique to the franchise. For example, Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask had, obviously, the whole timer system. That was so weird and stuff. But, you know, that was a in-game mechanic only for that, you know. That was part of the whole puzzling part of it. You know, because the game mechanic always, you know, backs up the series mechanic here. So the game mechanic here in Super Mario Galaxy is the spin. Pretty much everything is based around it, from how enemies are designed to, you know, where enemies are placed, to how big jump gaps are in each level. You know, everything is based all around the jump. The spin jump. So, you know, just the fact that it reinforces its, you know, main mechanic by doing that so subtly, you know, just, you know, I think it's pretty smart. And oh my gosh, gotta watch out for that, because that would push us all the way down and that would stink. Okay, let's just do some more jumps right here, and yes, we are on the final stretch. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you've especially enjoyed the video. And yes, I will see you next time on Super Mario Galaxy! I will see you then.